to master English small talk for professional situations scenarios? Stay tuned because in this video, I'll share 6 different English speaking scenarios with different prompts that you can use to start successful conversations in the workplace. Hello, I'm Francisca, English Confidence Mentor. Welcome back to my channel. So if you're excited to watch this video, hit the subscribe button and also the notification bell because I publish videos every Friday to help tech-savvy, ambitious professionals to go from feeling limited, frustrated to confident, fluent so that they can attract more professional growth and career opportunities. So let's start with these prompts and scenarios. So I know many times I've been nervous in different new business ventures, professional meetings, and that is because new experiences equals new people. And so what you wanna do first is really start dialogues, start conversations to break the ice, to build rapport, so that you can nurture those relationships and get specific outcomes. Now, what is small talk? So small talk is light, informal conversation. It's like an introduction of unimportant topics. It's just a talk that breaks the ice and warms up a dialogue with a new person that could be your boss, a coworker, a colleague, or a new potential client. So let's go to scenario number one. So the first scenario is hopping on a call with a new potential client, customer. And for this, you have to be observant. You have to be an observer. What do I mean by this? So let's say that you're gonna hop on a call on Zoom and you wanna like establish common ground. You wanna establish a connection before going into the important stuff in the conversation. So let's say it's a sales call, right? You know that you wanna get a new client, but first you have to build rapport. First you have to break the ice. So what you will do is you would notice like if there is something interesting in the room, maybe there's a book that this person was reading, or maybe they have a painting that you really like. So let's say that this person was reading Atomic Habits, right? And so you can use this prompt, and this prompt would be in the past tense. Didn't you just love it when James Clear wrote about how habit building starts by you taking little baby steps? So this can be applied to any other book that you like. And what this would do would first establish common ground. Or if it's a painting that's on the wall, you observed it. Didn't you just love that the painting was actually a painting during troublesome times for the author? He was in a deep depression, right? And so there's nothing that unites more than art. And so remember these prompts. Didn't you just love it when, or don't you just love that this was, you will observe that when you say this, this person will have a lot to work on because this person obviously loves the book, obviously loves the painting. And so conversation will flow a lot smoother after that. You will be building rapport and you will get into like the meat of the conversation. Now, as the word says, small talk, it's very important that you keep it short because that is not the end goal of the conversation, right? The end goal is not discussing a book or discussing a painting, right? The end goal is really getting the new client, let's say. So the second scenario is actually jumping on a networking meeting. So I was going to connect with this female entrepreneur. I knew this person was from the US. So, you know, little background research. What I use is this prompt. So where in the world are you? This is a very good location topic because I knew that she was from the US. But when I say where in the world are you, like specifically which city? She said, well, I'm in Forks. So Forks then guided us into a completely different topic, which was actually Twilight. Because Twilight, you know, the characters, the stories evolved in Forks, and so it became a really lighthearted conversation. And it all started because of this prompt, like, so where in the world are you? Like, in which city are you? Speaking about a particular location is a very common topic on small talk because it's something that unites us all, like culturally, and it can be a really interesting icebreaker for a networking meeting. So third scenario is, let's say you're going to speak with an authority, and this happened to me recently. I was making contacts to really get my business out there, get my program out there. And so this person informed me that this authority really cares about personal development. And so what I did is I used this prompt. I know your company is very focused on personal development. I myself, as a mentor, care deeply about personal and professional growth. So I think my program would fit perfectly the needs of your employees. Remember, I know your company really cares about, and then you insert, you know, the thing that the company would care about, and then you align it with let's say a common ground, a common thread as to why you're aligned, why you'd be a perfect fit to sort of form a strategic alliance with that company. This will remove a lot of nerves, because we all know that when we're in professional meetings, we're like very worried about the outcome. So words can just float away. That's normal. And so when you do this, that immediately gives you more confidence, because you're already establishing common ground. You're winning points because that person knows that you care, and you're not just there to just win. You are really caring about a win-win potential situation. So the next scenario comes from when I was doing an internship with a London company. I was just about to finish my internship. It was about 6 months, and another student was gonna come in, and I know like how nerve-wracking it can feel to be the new person. And so they told me to have a little chat, kind of like a mentor mentee sort of thing. When you're gonna have a new conversation with a new person, you have to know that this person is gonna be nervous, that this person is gonna be excited, that this person is gonna want to know about your previous experience. Yeah, I've already been a couple of months and she was just entering. What I did was, first of all, I knew that she was in like the music business and I love music and all of that. So I used the following prompt. I see that you have studied, for example, I see that you have studied a music business. I find this career super interesting. So I see that you have studied. I find this career, you know, super interesting. There are several adjectives that you can use. Like, I find this career super exciting. Super fulfilling, you know. And so what you would add then is that I've had my shared experience with music, you know. I've been a pianist for many years, and I also enjoy marketing. And so again, you are doing a really nice sort of like connection with the person, which will allow like the rest of the conversation to be more fun. So I'd love to know if you have been in this professional scenarios in English. Have you used these prompts? If not, I'm excited to know which prompts you're going to use today to improve your confidence and fluency in speaking English for professional situations. And if you're excited, make sure you comment below and give this video a like. So now the fifth scenario is a lot to do with conflict solving, problem solving. See, I have this particular situation with a mentor of mine where, you know, let's say that a problem arises. And so the best thing to do is just being honest, right? And so in this case, what I did was, I know I was in the wrong because, so an example, there had been some problems with a payment that hadn't arrived in time. This would be the way to use it. I know I was in the wrong because I wasn't completely honest with, you know, the date that the payment was going to arrive. So you see how this can really be a starter, you know, for you to strengthen our relationship. So this prompt really serves to keep conversations authentic. It also serves to really deepen the relationship with a person, making sure that things stay professional. The sixth scenario is actually when you're interviewing someone. So you're doing a little bit of market research, let's say of a product or service, and to get great answers, you have to ask great questions, because sometimes the person can be a little bit nervous and you're the one that's guiding the conversation, which is why small talk is so important. And so you want to provide a safe space, a safe container, a safe environment for the person to answer. You want to ask the right questions, and that the person knows that you care about them and that you're listening. So for example, this prompt can the IC and how does it make you feel? So for example, what's your biggest frustration when it comes to English communication? And the person answers and game over. No, you would do a follow, but IC, like, and how does that make you feel? Like, tell me a little bit more about that. So these two prompts, how does that make you feel? Tell me a little bit more about that. Again, goes for a deeper conversation than just staying in small talk. So those were the six different scenarios. And I know that you want to communicate so confidently and fluently that you just jump in a meeting and conversations feel peaceful, easy, fun, and that you get specific outcomes out of that. So I invite you personally to join the English Confidence Method, where I help tech-savvy professionals go from limited and frustrated to completely confident and fluent English. I do this every day. This is my Venus Zone. And so if you would love to have a chat with a real human being, no, do not worry. These conversations do not have to be in English. I'll make sure that I leave a link below so that you can book a call, because spots are limited every week in my calendar. So make sure you book it. You can also send an email to Francisca@englishtothrive.com, and we'll make sure to reply as soon as possible. So do not forget to give the video a like, to subscribe to the channel, and hit the notification bell, because in the next video, I am going to talk about habit building to reach your English goals. So make sure that you stay tuned and watch this video next to continue with your English confidence journey.